aquí con David Warraby, que es el que ha eliminado a Mato y es un corredor que se hizo la transcontinental, corrió desde California hasta Nueva York, 64 días corriendo más de 3.000 millas. You ran more than 64 days, 3.000 miles from California to New York, no?
20 years ago, I was involved in an incredible experience. For the first time in 64 years in the United States, they held a transcontinental foot race. Okay, back in 1928 and 1929, they held this during the Roaring Twenties in the United States. They held a race called the Bunyan Derby. And at that time, there was a sports agent, C.C. Pyle, who was kind of like the Donald King of today's sports environment. And so 64 years passed, and two gentlemen from the United States decided we want to recreate the Bunyan Derby of 1928 and 29. So they got together and put a race. They went across the United States and searched out places to stay for the runners and found sponsors. And on June 20th, 1992, 29 of us started from Huntington Beach, California, and we ran for 64 straight days, averaging 48 miles a day.
Wow.
No days off, unlike the Tour de France. The Tour de France, sure, they get days off. And so no days off, 29 of us started.
How many finished?
And 13 of us finished, okay?
And you win.
And luckily for me, I drew pocket aces and I ended up winning. I didn't lead the whole way. I didn't take the lead until day 9 or 10. And then I ended up losing it. I ended up holding the lead till day 36. And then I lost the lead because you get injured when you're running 3,000 miles. And 6 days later, on day 42, I retook the lead and ended up extending my lead to 18 and a half hours with 12 days to go. And then I just slid into the finish, injured the whole way, and was lucky enough to win.
It was congratulations.
Well,
20 years later.
But 20 years later, the anniversary was June 20th of this year, and we ran till August 20th, 22nd. So I'm still in that 20-year time
and
frame.
And for celebrating it, you played a World Series, or it's your first time here?
This is my third main event. I've played in the World Series for 3 or 4 years. I've cashed 2 or 3 times in lesser events. 2 years ago, I ended up on day 4, 99 away from the finish. I got pocket aces cracked. Okay, great experience. Last year, okay, and this is incredible. Okay, last year, main event, I busted out on the first day. Okay, I was in a lot of pain. I didn't know what was wrong. I was on medication. When I got back to Southern California, I went to the doctor and I had cancer. Okay, I had lymphoma, and I ended up going through chemotherapy and radiation. And as of February of this year, I'm clean. I'm free of cancer.
Really, congratulations.
Thank you very much. It's amazing. You know, it's like someone's looking over me. Lady Luck is looking over me. And here, too. I mean, I had a hand today when I busted out. And, well, I could have busted out. I had ace king against queens. And on the river, I hit an ace. Just like Barry Greenstein's book, Ace on the River. But I could feel it coming, you know. And there's, you know, you can't control it, but, you know, you got to...
But you have the sensation, no? Like, oh, it's coming, you were relaxed.
I don't worry, because you can't... The only thing you can control is how well you play, okay? You can't control the way the cards are going to fall. So all you can do is mind your own game and don't let the competition take you off your own game. And the cards will determine where the placings are going to be. Yeah.
And you have a hand with a Spanish player that finally you busted him out with aces versus nines.
Mm-hmm.
But before, everybody's asking. Mm-hmm. I've heard from someone, I cannot tell you who,
that's okay,
that you have the full house of aces.
Yep.
And fours.
Yeah, I turn the full house.
You turn the full house, and you decide to play it slow and check
racing. What did I do on the turn? I think I checked, he bet, and I think I smooth called him.
You smooth called.
I smooth called, and then I think I checked on the river,
he
bet, and I pushed, and
You know, he fought Nats. Nats, flush Nats. Yeah, king seven of spades. He had the flush.
Yeah, okay. All right. So well, that was a good lay down for him.
He rivered a flush?
Right. Yeah, was it the nut flush?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, the ace of spades was on the board. Okay.
Yeah, he said that.
How did he know?
He know because you
I'm so tight. I don't play no hands.
Well, you play and you call the press and you say.
Oh, Hollywood!
Okay. So that's why he decided to fold, and later on he plays.
Took him a long time though to fold. It was close. You know, it was close.
Anyway, we wish you the best of luck in the tournament, and thank you very much.
You're
welcome. Keep fighting, keep running.
Absolutely.
Keep doing fine. Thank you very much.
Great, guys.